Hello and good morning.
Morning.
Good morning.
All right, we'll give people another minute or so to get started. I get myself situated as well. All right, today is January 29th, and this is CNCF's Sick App Delivery bi-weekly call. Just a little bit of a reminder before we get started. These are recorded, so only say things you want the internet to know about forever. And let me go ahead and share our meeting notes. All right. So, like I said, today is the 29th of January. We'd like to keep an attendance list to see who shows up. So feel free to add yourself. I will actually put the link in the chat. Once I find the link for the chat, there it is. Yeah, all right, so today, just noticing that our agenda is way shorter than it was 2 weeks ago. Time allowing, we can definitely make it longer, but I wanted to get started off with the first item on the list. And is there anyone new to Sick App Delivery and want to introduce themselves and why they decided to show up?
I could start. I'm Stephen Levine. I'm on the core team of the Cloud Native Build Packs project, and I'm here just to answer any questions if they come up as the AppSig looks at Cloud Native Build Packs entering incubation.
All right, sounds good. Welcome. All right, anyone else?
I'm Xander. I'm one of the contributors of the Cloud Native Build Packs project, and I'm sort of just here for the same reason.
All right. So anyone else from the Cloud Native Build Pack project wants to introduce themselves?
Yeah, should we do like a group introduction? I'm Javier. Yes, I'm the platform maintainer for the Cloud Native Build Packs, here more as a witness to the discussion, really.
All right. Sounds
at least,
good.
At least one more. I'm Micah, also a contributor on the Cloud Native Build Packs, particularly focused on Windows.
Okay, sounds good.
Hi, I'm Peter Elko. I'm with VMware from Pivotal. I work on a platform engineering team, and we are interested in learning and helping applications teams move to Kubernetes.
Okay. Hey, I'm trying to figure out who's Mike is. Is that Jed Record? So last week,
Andreas sent it looks like it.
I cannot mute people.
Who's the host?
I am not signed in as the host.
Nobody is.
Nobody is signed in as the host. There we go. Well, thank you. All right, so moving down our agenda items. A little bit ago, we put out a call for a working group on air-gapped environments. And there is lots of good responses from that. And so the next step in this, I swear there was there was definitely lots of good responses to this. So the next step is to get all the interested people together. And let's get this conversation going. I am not 100% sure of the process for creating an official work group in CNCF. That was something that Alice and I talked about earlier this week. But what I want to do is let everyone know who's here now or might watch this call or even on the mailing list is that we'll send out a message today about this to get this moving on. And I see that Alice put it out in the meeting that we would put the discussion of creating a working group. Is anyone here that actually responded to that? Oh, guess not.
Can I ask a quick question, Brian?
You sure can.
What is the structure of working groups in the CNCF? They were originally started and then they were kind of converted into SIGs, and the intention was SIGs would take over for much of what the working groups had been doing. So when we talk about these new working groups, what's the scope, the structure, the plan? Do you know what that is?
No, that's actually, that is one of my jobs today, actually, is to figure out exactly what it is, because, you know, we did working group work with the Kubernetes SIGs, and I think they are a little bit different. So I do want to make sure that we do this the right way and get them recognized in the correct way. I do also know that there are other working groups right now, so this will not be the first, but I just want to make sure that we are doing it correct and we can get this organized and get meetings set up, and then also determine, because working groups are not forever or should not be forever, what will be the end goal of this working group and what are we working towards? And maybe what some of those first deliverables will be. So, well, that's actually a very short conversation. And I have a question, actually more of a comment. Google Docs allows you to draw on the canvas. It's pretty, but yeah, open up your own Google Doc and do that. All right.
So Brian, I don't see the drawing on it.
Oh, I see it. Can you see it on my,
we can see it in the screenshot. I just cannot see it on the version that I have opened. Just so you know, it's not everybody.
All right. Well, just because of that, I'm going to hit reload. Oh, still there.
Actually, it might be on the screen share itself Zoom rather than, yeah.
There we go. All right. Good to know. All right. So so more information will be on the mailing list today for the air-gapped environments. Next is a little bit of discussion on a new working group for operator best practices. Based on our conversation last week, we had lots of great insights on, as we discussed, operator framework and what that entails. But we also had, you know, there's the operator framework is not the end all be all answer to operators in this cloud native space. So what we wanted to do is create another working group for interested people who want to help define this space. And just a little bit of commentary before that is that I did actually take a very long look at the operator framework and all its components to try to see how it was put together. And I realized that, you know, there's some great places for specs to be created. So an example would be on the front end, so the way that an operator framework, they have this idea of manifests that include cluster service versions, their term, and they are put into this SQLite file and serve as a registry. That's interesting, but that's an implementation detail. Let's figure out how we can actually standardize on maybe the cluster service version is a good idea, and actually it could actually work with pretty much anything. So let's actually focus there. And then on the other side for the operator hub piece, because I know there's some conversation on that, is how do we include things like Helm and other types of things in this operator hub? And looking at that piece, you know, it's there's the way the operator hub works is that it makes gRPC calls to a registry, and what's in there doesn't really matter. So there's definitely some work that can be done there too. And this actually work would help the ecosystem a lot if we could actually figure this out. So what I'll do is, let me actually write this down so I don't forget, is I'll send a message out to the mailing list today and to say that we want to actually start this idea out. Go ahead, Matt.
I just kind of had a comment and a question. One, with the things around the operator hub and the registry, it might be worth you reaching out to Dan Cohen on this, just because of the work he's been got going on in the background and the CNCF hub type stuff. Just tie off with him. He may have some insight there on things that are happening or in works that may be helpful, fruitful, or useful. The other is, it sounds like the output of this is specs. And I know the CNCF, well, we do have a couple of specs in there. The goal is not to be a specs organization. Is the goal here more specs or guidance, or what's the outcome?
So, because, I mean, yeah, that word spec is super overloaded. The way that I think of a spec is not something organized by a governing body or a standards organization. It's more of, and actually spec is probably the wrong word. It's more of that concept of we have this concept of operators and we want to put them into something so they can be searched and they can be installed, and it's not really owned by one group. What does that think? And I don't know. And you know, that's actually up to the working group. I may or may not participate in that working group. So I want others to actually sit down and think about that as well. And that would be more the recommendation from the working group. So I'm not saying what should happen. I'm just saying, here are some ideas.
Okay. Yeah, I know one of the things on the Kubernetes side is going in, a lot of times we like to have the outcome, you know, what's going to be generated and why and what's needed. So that's why I asked those questions. I also noticed, you know, you talked about the service version in a cluster, and it struck me that that is even a bit of an assumption that the operator you're running is designed to host a service inside of a cluster. There's lots of people who will have a single instance of an application and an operator for it, but it's not meant to be a cluster-wide service. And I don't think that gets talked about much, because a lot of the people who are doing it are actually doing service-based setups. But there are a lot of folks out there who are doing a single instance of an application and an operator to manage that, and they're not running it as a cluster service.
Yeah, so the cluster service version is just the name of the file of the CRD that Red Hat created or CoreOS created. I was actually don't even look at it as a service. It's just the name of that thing. So
yeah, it does speak a little bit to the thought process behind it by its naming. Mm-hmm. And I just want to bring up that there's other ways besides as a service that operators can be done. And so whoever's working on this, I would suggest that they take into account those other things as well.
Right. So actually, I
can actually share maybe some light on this. So you're right, it's called a service, but if you look at these back of the CSV, you see that it has the concept of install modes, which covers exactly the scenario that you just described, Matt, where the operator is really just scoped to a namespace, looking after a single application instance and is not offering something cluster-wide as a service. So the name might be a little bit misleading there, and it's also a little bit of a mouthful, and that's why we are actually in the process of thinking about changing that.
Plus one. All right.
I quickly wanted to add something to the previous discussion about specs. It's a different working group, but we have actually, I'm just gonna paste this in here in the agenda notes, opened a cap as part of work in the SIG cluster add-ons group with regards to describing how we ship metadata describing operators. So whereas CSV is one format and Helm is another, we wanted to see if there is consensus on shipping any kind of manifest describing an operator in a container image. So very closely modeled to OCI, with the caveat that OCI isn't fully spec'd out yet, and that there are not a lot of registries that actually support it probably with the MIME type that we would need. So there was a proposal put out that I've linked in the doc here that describes how we would generically use a container image and labels to describe the content. So it's curable and it's something you can put on a registry. And we want to use that as a discussion basis going forward to ensure there is a standard consensus around how we package metadata for operators. Could probably be extended to other stuff, but that's kind of the scope right now, as this is the context on cluster add-ons. And we would put that in a container and ship that as part of, or ship that around, and then have that store the actual metadata. I think this would, in the mid to long term, tie into the discussion that Matt and I started on OperatorHub.io, how we standardize capturing the visual catalog data in a central place.
Are you familiar with the, what's it called? The new artifacts that they're working on in the OCI that allows you to store non-container images in registries?
I think I heard of that, but I probably need to revisit that again. We looked at Auras actually as a quick POC for that. That's OCI as storage. And like Evan, the opener of the DPR also put out a little POC implementation of that. Eventually we came down to just using container images because that's the tooling that everybody seems to have available and that all registries support.
Yeah. If you're curious, I dropped a link into the chat here to the artifacts repository. This is a newer thing where the OCI is looking at storing other things in, and Auras is the first implementation against that, being worked on by folks at Microsoft and Docker to get working. And so Docker apps and CNAB are the first two things I think that are really looking at it. In Helm, we're looking at it as well, but it's basically being able to store things other than container images in there. And so if you don't want to package it in a container and then have to get to things inside of the container, this may be a route to do it. If you're curious about more details on it, I'm happy to chat with you for a little bit or introduce you to some other folks who know more, but this is kind of the direction the OCI is taking for those things.
Yeah, that makes a lot of sense. And I think I've seen that before. We are fully aware that what we are proposing in the cap is a temporary workaround until OCI is fully spec'd out and we have almost all registries out there supported, and it's easy to get a mind type in, right? That's kind of the hurdle that we are seeing right now. That's really no easy way to do that.
Okay, that makes sense. I just want to make sure everybody here and you and everybody is familiar with the work. So.
All right, sounds good. Hold on, get my video. I accidentally closed that window, so let me reshare it. There we go. All right, so like I was saying before, what we'll do is we'll put it on the mailing list and also ping the Slack channel that we are going to be creating a group. And what we'll work on in the meantime is thinking of what would a deliverable be for that working group? All right, I'm going to move this around a little bit. Okay, so the next item here is who brought up the next steps for the operator framework TOC vote?
That would have been me, Brian.
Okay, so actually I do have some news. So yesterday, Alice and I worked through we have one more set of comments that will be sent out today, and then this will be in the TOC's hands, and then we'll try to figure out and let between either you or Diane know, hey, this is what's going on, and this is whenever this vote is going to happen. But at a high level, actually, I'll just read what we have here. We are going to agree to accept this from the SIGAP delivery point of view, but we had a couple of action items. And one thing that we need from the CMCF is that it's easy when a singular project and that lives in a repo that actually says, hey, we want to be in a sandbox or incubation. That's an easy decision. It's also easy whenever you have a project like OpenTelemetry where you have multiple projects because you're going to have a repo for every single language that you're trying to work with. What we've run into with the Argo project and with with Open Framework is like Open Framework. It's the Open SDK. It's OLM. It's the operator registry. It's operator hub. So there are four things. And now the guidance that we're trying to figure out, and we don't think this should be a blocker, is how do we proceed whenever we have these projects that are not just one thing, but they are a suite of things. And I don't think it should be blocked because it is a suite of things, because you know what, life is complex and this actually solves a big problem. But we want to remove that uncertainty from this whole entire discussion. So that was, those are the things that we are going to bring up. Let me see here. Yep, that would be it. There were other things on the list. Around CSV, like do we want to, when we suggest this, are we actually getting into standards work? But we decided not to bring that up. So that is, for your point of view, Daniel, that's what's coming on. So we'll submit it today and then we'll be on them. And then whenever next TOC meeting, we'll make sure to bring it up. Hey, let's get this front and center. Yes, Matt.
Well, I was just gonna point out, the next TOC meeting will be the first TOC meeting for the new TOC that's in election. And if it's anything like last time, this may not come up or have time to come up. Just as a warning, it's kind of that transition point. There are several members who are stepping away, who are not running again. And last time they let them give advice and they talked through a lot of things. And it was a very different kind of meeting for that first meeting because about half the TOC is being reelected right now.
Yeah, and we also have another meeting too, where the TOC participates, and we have a CNCF SIG chairs meeting. So I'll work with Amy to figure out what the best option is, so we can move this along because no one likes to wait.
No, it's just a kind of a bump in the road, hiccup time where the election cycle is going. And the other thing is when you're looking at the suite of things, when Helm came in, we had Monocular and Helm and a handful of things that came in as a suite. Well, Helm was the primary thing. There was a whole supporting thing system around it already that came in as well. So if you're looking for something that had more than one thing coming together, more than one repo, different languages, it's kind of a suite of things. Helm is an example of that happening.
All right. Yeah. Well, that's definitely something that we will cite as hey, this is proof of something that already exists. Okay. Let's see. All right, so I actually did have another item here. I know there were a lot of Cloud Native Build Packs people on the meeting. What we are waiting on now is word from CNCF on that. I Alice and I, when we talked 2 days ago, I did bring it up and say, hey, what's going on with that? And just come to find out we are waiting on CNCF. So my action item out of this meeting is we will respond back to whoever submitted it. I think that was Terrence Lee. So we will actually respond back. And so hopefully by the end of the week, we can have some update for you for your project and what's going on with it. Because actually right now, I don't know. So any other things for the agenda? Because if not, this will be a short meeting today. All right. Well, you all are super quiet. So we have a few things coming out of this meeting. So we have the follow-up for the air gapped work group. What will come out of that is another message saying, hey, we're still on it, and we need to work with we need to figure out exactly how we create a work group. For the operator work group, we need to figure out what a goal for that operator work group is, and be sharing on the mailing list and on Slack. And then for the Open Framework project, what we need to do is get this in front of the right people, and we'll figure out the best way to do that, to say that, hey, the SIGAP delivery is behind this. And also for the the CNB group, what we're going to do is figure out where that stands. So I will say that there's I really want to thank the projects that went through this, like the Argo team and the CNB team and the Operator Framework team, because the questionnaire that we created for this process, I think the TOC is actually going to take it up and make it their standard. So that's a that's a good piece of news out of there. So without that, my list is done. If there's nothing else, we can move on with our days. All right, sounds good. Let's move on. Thank you for showing up, everybody. And if anything, we're on Slack. You can ping, and we'll try to figure out what's going on. Have a good day.
All right, thank you.
All right, bye.